Welcome back to another month of survival in the Nox Exclusion Zone. If you haven't seen the previous episode, make sure to go watch that first. Otherwise, this story continues on day 34, where Tough Guy spent the entire day preparing to leave, prioritized which elite he would bring on his future trip, as he intended to leave West Point for quite a while, and wasn't sure when he would come back. He wanted to ensure that he had everything that he would need in his future journey, while still leaving something back at the base, in case he ever came back. The next morning, he woke up early to drive to his new destination. He was driving across country, so he stopped early in Rosewood to find somewhere to sleep for the night. To ensure he would have enough time before the sun fell and not get trapped out in the dark, knew he would have to kill the zombies in the area to ensure it was safe. He cleared out some buildings on the outskirts and tried to make it further in town, but there were simply too many zombies, and with the sun falling, he went back out to the outskirts and slept in one of the houses. It was day 36 and Tough Guy reached his destination, Raven Creek. Unfortunately, Raven Creek was blocked off due to a quarantine when the outbreak first hit, but it was nothing that he couldn't get through with enough determination. The first roadblock in his way, both metaphorically and literally, was a military checkpoint. The front gate was open, but there was a second gate that was completely blocked off, and a bunch of zombies. He spent the entire day killing the zombies and making sure that the entrance was clear. Inside of the checkpoint, there were military tents, where he managed to find some weapons and ammo. The day went by fast, most of it consisting of driving and killing, but he had gotten quite a lot accomplished. The next morning, Tough Guy used the guns and ammo he had found to their full extent. While the part of the checkpoint he was in was clear, on the other side of the fences, there were hundreds of zombies. He blasted as many as he could through the fences, in order to ensure that it was clear enough to break through the wall and clear the path in the next road. He did that for most of the day, until the evening where he thought it was clear enough that he could use the sledgehammer to break down the iron gate that blocked him from continuing forward. By the time he had opened it up, it was already getting dark and the day ended. With the initial checkpoint clear, Tough Guy continued forward in an attempt to enter the city. He drove past the checkpoint, down the road which led into a tunnel. The tunnel was once again blocked off by a checkpoint and full of shambling corpses. He cleared out the zombies inside and scavenged anything that was left behind. He tore down the fences that blocked the road and continued forward out the other side. He was met by an impromptu roadblock full of destroyed and burnt cars. Intertwined with the cars, there was even more zombies, presumably occupants of the city. Tough Guy knew he was getting close, but this was still a major obstacle that prevented him from getting inside. He took the rest of the day trying to clear what zombies he could, but ultimately fell back to sleep the night away. On the morning of day 39, Tough Guy continued down the road and found the last military checkpoint that led into the city. The only downside to this checkpoint is that there were literally thousands of zombies in the checkpoint and in the surrounding buildings that would definitely hear all the gunshots. He knew it would be a challenge, but he was willing to take it on. So he spent the rest of day 39 and all of day 40 killing any zombie that dared to face him. He pushed on with every gunshot, showing his determination to enter the city one way or another. Day 41 was lost to the sands of time. No one knows for sure what happened, but it was most likely a day filled with the brutality of zombie killing. However, on day 42, the checkpoint was mostly clear. Tough Guy looted the guardhouse and towers that loomed over the checkpoint, and that afternoon, he gained access into the city. There were still plenty of zombies inside the city walls. nightfall was quickly approaching. He decided to return back to the tunnel, to sleep, and then return back to the city in the morning. He woke up very excited to explore the city and start looting the nearby buildings first thing. He brought a double barrel shotgun and plenty of ammo to ensure he could clear out any hordes that he came across. He wasn't sure what the city held, so he spent the entire day exploring, looting, and killing. Tough Guy wanted to find somewhere more permanent inside of the city limits, but many zombies still blocked his path. He focused his efforts on the northwest of the checkpoint, up by a firehouse that he thought was a good potential spot for a base. As a part of Tough Guy's MO, he cleared the surrounding area of zombies, or at least attempted to for the day, before he even considered using the firehouse as a base. While clearing out the area around the firehouse, Tough Guy stumbled across a gun store that was just across the street. He grabbed a sledgehammer and broke in to see what it had, but it wasn't much. The store ended up having more zombies inside than it did ammo. Over the next hour, it went from a bright, clear, sunny day to looking like a level in hard rain. He tried to continue to explore, but the storm was too rough and forced him to stay inside of a nearby apartment complex. He thought it was unfortunate that the storm had hit just as he had gained access into the city and started to explore. He woke up to a clear and sunny morning and resumed his exploration of the city. He thought that it was fortunate the storm only lasted a day, and by the next morning it was clear and he was ready to resume everything like nothing had happened. Tough Guy was wrong. By noon, it was once again overcast and rainy. The rain wasn't as heavy compared to the previous day, which allowed him to continue to explore at least a little bit, but ultimately it still slowed him down. Day 47. Tough Guy dove deeper into the city's complex layout to explore what secrets it held. He looted various different buildings, in between killing any zombies that roamed the streets. He continued south and found an extremely large horde of zombies surrounding the walls of the police station. He attempted to start clearing them out, but it was late into the day and he was too tired to do anything. He left the area, planning to return soon and see what contents the police station held. It was day 48 and Tough Guy decided to lay low and clean up the area around the city entrance. That entailed cleaning up some of the sporadic groups of zombies and ensuring that the nearby stores were looted. And that afternoon, he used a nearby sedan to pull the car wrecks out of the checkpoint and ensured that his future vehicles could go in and out. He noticed that the checkpoint roads were a bit tight, and he wasn't sure that he would actually be able to get a vehicle through there. So he planned to come by for the next couple days to remove the fences and sandbags that blocked off the checkpoint road. Day 49 consisted of Tough Guy using his sledgehammer to tear down the checkpoint walls to make it easier for vehicles to pass through. He tore down not only the sandbags that blocked the road, but also the tall barbed wire fences that lined the edges. By the end of the day, he used the sedan to pull even more vehicle wrecks off of the road to ensure that it was clear and easy to drive through. The next day, he worked out in the rain, attempting to finish tearing down the remaining fences and sandbags that blocked his way. He viewed this work as very important, as he would ensure any vehicles could go in and out of the city very easily.
Well, we worked so hard to build a little house together, in the snow or the rain or the ice cold wind, whenever. No matter what the weather, we're together.
The next day, the rain continued off and on as Tough Guy wandered the streets, clearing horde after horde. He felt lost and unsure of where to go in this very large city he found himself. Fighting was the only thing he knew how to do. Why did he even want to come to the city? How does he keep going? Move forward. He had no answers. The morning of day 52, he had remembered the police station and tried to make his way down there. He killed zombie after zombie, and the sun was setting, but he had managed to get inside the police station It was dark and he didn't have time to loot much, so he ran back home, intending to come back tomorrow. After a long night in one of the police station's holding cells, Tough Guy found a police SUV that was in the parking lot with an open window that strangely had keys in the form of wires. He packed up his spoils from the police station into the SUV and drove back to his firehouse base. The day was still bright, and he went out to scout nearby stores and POIs. He still wasn't that sure of the area around him in the city and what nearby places there were, but he wanted to find out. Day 54 and 55 were spent organizing and retrieving loot at the firehouse. He went back and made sure to grab all his trailers from the original military checkpoint and to ensure that everything inside the firehouse was organized. He mainly just wanted to take a break to collect his thoughts after fighting for 2 to 3 days and wanted to get all the boring things out of the way that needed to be done while he wanted to do them. Previously on day 53, Tough Guy noted a weird looking compound in the corner of the city he hadn't yet explored. He returned on day 56, and when he was pulling up to the entrance, he noticed a gun store that was right across the street. There was some good stuff inside, but he was more curious about the compound and decided that he would come back later to pick it all up. He wasn't sure what was inside the compound, but the barbed wire fences piqued his interest. Ultimately, it ended up being a large freighter center with tons of industrial supplies. He made sure to check all of the containers and the multiple buildings inside of the compound. He grabbed what he could and put it into his car, even though it couldn't hold much. He packed it up and left, hoping to return in a couple of days to make sure he grabbed everything else. The next morning, he drove back to the gun store to gather what supplies it had left. He spent the entire morning looting and transferring it back to base. He returned around noon, and upon entering the garage, he realized that he not only needed to reorganize everything, but to also increase the amount of storage space that he had. He made minor changes to fix the currently broken system, but he knew that he would need to completely revamp his storage area in the near future. After those looting extravaganzas, Tough Guy started to feel bored and cooped up in his base. He simply wanted to go out and explore the city streets, seeing what it had to offer. It felt like he has done that multiple times throughout the month, but Raven Creek was simply too big. He did not know what to do or where to go. He just simply went with the flow and hoped to experience something immaculate.